Hello, friends. Welcome back to Music with Miss S. Today, we're going to explore a piece of music called The Carnival of the Animals by Camille Saint-Saëns. Let's sing our welcome song to get started. Welcome to music. Glad you're here. Gonna do some singing. Gonna use our ears. We're gonna have a lot of fun, 'cause music time has just begun. Welcome to music. Glad you're here. First, friends, we're gonna read a story and hear some music that describes the animals with instruments. Listen along with me, and then we'll talk about our favorite animals. The Carnival of the Animals. Welcome to our carnival, where birds and beasts and such behave a lot like people do, at times a bit too much. You'll meet the regal lion, and the captivating swan, the irritating donkeys that prattle on and on. You'll meet a tortoise and some fish with undulating fins. Welcome to our carnival. The music now begins. The hens all rush around the yard. They hurry, hurry, hurry. They peck, peck, peck and cluck, cluck, cluck. They scurry, scurry, scurry. They fuss and fret and fuss with feathers in a flurry, until they rest upon their nest and cease their senseless worry. The hens each lay a single egg, then sit on it contented. The rooster treats this as news, as though it were unprecedented. With puffed up chest he crows and crows, till he appears demented. He seems to think a chicken egg was something he invented. They haven't any manners, and they haven't any sense. There's not a word that anyone can say in their defense. Their ways are so unsavory, they'll never get ahead. They are donkeys of the wild. That's all that need be said. The tortoise lugs his house about and lumbers on all fours. He clearly never seems to be completely out of doors. The tortoise is a cautious sort, not known for being bold. And so the tortoise lives to be exceptionally old. The tortoise never hurries and is happily resigned to being late for dinner and to being left behind. The tortoise doesn't ask for more if he can do with less. Perhaps that is the secret of the tortoise's success. An elephant never forgets to remember the things he remembers to never forget. An elephant knows that it snows in December, that summer is warmer and water is wet. An elephant's ears are a genuine wonder. An elephant's trunk is an elephant's pride. His footfalls are often mistaken for thunder. If you're in the neighborhood, do step aside. When elephants gather, the ground starts to tremble beneath the great weight of their ponderous feet. Be glad there are elephants left to assemble. Without them, our planet would feel incomplete. This fact is essential about kangaroos. They hop energetically wherever they choose. They hop over rocks, over fences and streams, and probably hop in their kangaroo dreams. When they aren't sleeping or swallowing food, they hop and they hop as though being pursued. For hopping's an action they cannot refuse. This fact is essential about kangaroos. In a tank filled to the brim, little fishes slowly swim, endlessly from place to place, rarely varying their pace. There is little that they know. They blow kisses as they go. They don't notice what they see, or their own monotony. Each one has no other wish than to be a little fish, neither jubilant nor glum, in a small aquarium. They love to loudly bray and bray, and bray away both night and day, determined that their brays be heard. They're both obnoxious and absurd. They bray when it's calm and warm. They bray throughout a raging storm, to fill the world with coarse hee-haws. Sometimes without the briefest pause, appears to be their only cause. Oh, cuckoo, cuckoo, cuckoo. We must number you among those creatures with no interest in parenting their young. You slyly lay your egg within some smaller bird's abode, thus demonstrating that you lack the slightest moral code. Oh, cuckoo, cuckoo, cuckoo. It's no wonder you're reviled, permitting that unwitting bird to cultivate your child. They flitter here, they flitter there, enjoying every breeze, and twitter songs of happiness amid the sheltering trees. They build their nests, they hatch their eggs, they warble as they thrive. With every note they tell the world, it's good to be alive. Practice, 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 our piano teacher screeches. We practice, 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 but we can't play what she teaches. Although we try our very best on every single scale, we always seem to fumble and our little fingers fail. But we practice, practice, practice as she screeches, screeches, screeches. And if we keep on practicing, we'll soon play what she teaches. Fossils, you entirely lack the basic knack of coming back. For fossils, you're extinct, and so there's nowhere left for you to go. Poor fossils, long without a skin, today you simply don't fit in. One wonders if you were surprised to find that you'd been fossilized. The stately and beguiling swan glides slowly on the lake, with little but a ripple in her evanescent wake. Although she has no song to sing, no words that she can say, she's perfectly exquisite in her aqueous ballet. The swan is grand and glorious. She's poised at every turn, epitomizing elegance no other bird can learn. Though some may say she's just a swan and fairly commonplace, she's positively nonpareil at demonstrating grace. Our carnival is ending soon, as all things must in time. The music's almost over, we approach the final rhyme. In moments, all the animals will take their parting bow. We hope you'll visit us again, but say farewell for now. In our musical story, we heard about so many animals. We heard about chickens, donkeys, a swan, birds, an aquarium full of fish, the cuckoo, the tortoise, fossils, kangaroos, elephants, and piano players? My friends, do you think piano players are an animal? And fossils? Well, maybe they were an animal. The next part of our lesson is a choose your own adventure. Choose two or three of the animals you heard about in our story by clicking the timestamps in the video description below. Once you've gotten to your animal, ask yourself the question, how do these animals move? And dance along to the animal's song. We know so many ways to move our bodies. We can wiggle, grow, squirm, drift, unfold, explode, whirl, float. There are so many ways we can move like the animals we heard about. So look below in the video description and click on the animals you would like to explore.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you.
I hope you had fun exploring the Carnival of the Animals with me. Next week, we're going to talk about the instruments behind each animal and what makes them sound so alive. My friends, now it's time for our goodbye song. Sing with me. One, two, ready, sing. Time to go, it's time to go. Time to say goodbye. We'll sing and dance another day. So long, farewell, goodbye. Goodbye, my friends. I'll see you next week.